What's up guys, JV2017 here, and I'm super excited to bring you my first Contraptions Workshop DLC video. And for this first video, I thought it would make sense to do a basic overview of every new item introduced in this DLC. This will give those of you still wondering if you should buy the DLC a good idea of what you're paying for. On the other hand, if you already got the Contraptions Workshop in the Season Pass, I hope this video provides a basic rundown of how each new item works. Before we begin, I realize this video is a lot longer than my regular content, so I've left timestamps in the description below. If you're looking for something specific like machinery and conveyor belts towards the end of the video, check the description, click on that timestamp, and it'll bring you to whatever you're looking for. So let's hop into Starlight Drive-In and start building. The first category with new items is structures, and there are plenty of new things in structures. First off, we have warehouse, which I will say before I get into this, this is pretty much exactly the same as the barn from Far Harbor, but it's more warehouse themed. So let's go ahead and look at some of the things we can build. And first off, we have a giant prefab. This is the only actual prefab we have, but then we have a bunch of other different options like walls and roofs. So I'm just going to go ahead and build this and take a look inside real quick. It's pretty much exactly the same once again as the barn, and you can even put doors on it. It's pretty much the same structure as the barn prefab as well. So once again, you have things like wall corners. You can kind of corner off, section off of certain areas, and then, you know, roofs and whatnot, these wall corners, which again are very similar to what we already have with barns, but they're kind of more, you know, tin shack kind of shingle material, as you can tell right here. Oh, that's interesting. I can just put that right there. I didn't expect I could do that, but there you go. And so, you know, you have these more options, and then you kind of have some glass roof options, which is pretty cool. So, you know, you would never put that there, but just to show off, to show you guys, you know, you can make some pretty tall, impressive structures with the warehouse, which is pretty cool. You know, that's how it should be, because warehouses tend to get huge, and a lot of the machines that you can build and machinery and all that, the ball tracks, you know, require a lot of room. So if you want to make it inside, you'll need plenty of room for that. So we're hopping over out of prefabs into the floors. There's lots of different floor options here, and these really look like a nice, you know, clean concrete slash wood look. This right here is definitely concrete, as you can tell. This is definitely wood. So just going to show you guys a few different little things here. You kind of have half pieces there, so you can kind of put those together as you wish. And then these small little squares. So there's lots of different options if you want to kind of, you know, make ball tracks and whatnot and keep this as your foundation to keep them up on an even surface, then that's a really good idea for sure. And then we have pretty much the same basic stuff that was introduced with the concrete structures option with the last workshop DLC. So kind of this graded with the middle bar look right here. And then half of that right here, as you can tell, just like we have with the wood with no grates. And then you have a lot of different broken options. And so just going to put out some of those. And I guess this is if you want your you know, warehouse to have more of a natural look, you can absolutely go for that. And so that's all of the floor options for the warehouse. Now let's look at some of the walls. And so again, kind of you have this rusted shingle look. And so this, of course, should snap on to some of these, yeah, some of these flooring options right here. So I'm going to go ahead and put these up. Yeah, some of these are really torn down, worn down, kind of what you would expect from some of these options in Fallout. This one has a complete hole in it. That's pretty much a door right there, a door frame right there. So just going to put that down. So plenty of different cosmetic customization options there. Then you have kind of a nice half wall, which is interesting. I'm sure this will kind of, you know, attach, yeah, attach to the floors, which is pretty cool. If you want to section off certain areas inside of your warehouses or just do something like that, you can certainly do that. Then we have some windowed walls, which are also pretty cool. I'm going to place some of these just to show you guys. That might as well be a doorway as well. And then this can go somewhere like up here if it's gonna snap. No, it's not. It will snap here though, even though that doesn't make any sense. So lots of different options there. And then these kind of half walls, these are interesting. I think this is just an opening, honestly. Maybe we can get some of the barn type doors, and there are more barn type doors as openings. So let's see if we can get this to snap correctly. I guess that is just a wall. So if you want kind of a corner opening to your warehouse, you can run it that way as well. And these are just kind of very small half walls, very similar once again to what we got with the concrete building options in a Wasteland Workshop as well. Tons of different wall options, as you can tell. I don't think I need to really build any more of these. But you also have some greenhouse options. This is kind of the greenhouse kit that they were talking about, that they tweeted about before. And there's nothing that strictly says greenhouse. This is pretty much what it is here. And so there's just some nice windows, a nice, you know, opening right here for a door, if you want to go ahead and do that. And then other options like this, where you can kind of close it up, which are admittedly pretty cool. And so, as you can tell, there's a ton of stuff in warehouse. They kind of lumped greenhouse and warehouse together to give you this. And there's tons of stuff you could do with it. It's really cool, honestly. So if you wanted to kind of make a greenhouse for your plants and whatnot, it's a little, you know, it's a little crappy, but it's Fallout. And so you can't expect perfect kind of structures and whatnot. But this is pretty much what we get out of warehouse walls. That was only walls. Now we're going into roofs. And again, very similar, I've said a billion times already, to barns. And so you're going to get kind of the same slanted roof options here. Just kind of some broken, some not, in different places. Then you have a nice corner option here. So if you're trying to make a, you know, roofs out of scratch, you can, from scratch, I mean, you can just go ahead and do that, get the corner option there. And then just a regular roof, just like that. Kind of a roof with a little bit of a platform. If you need that, maybe you need to hang stuff from that. I'm sure you could do that as well. Just centerpiece roofs, roofs. So many roofs. And then this one right here, let's go ahead and put this on top, even though there's already one. I guess we're not going to do that, actually. Let's put it on top of our greenhouse. There we go. It's a beautiful greenhouse right there. Rafters, platforms on top of roofs, which is interesting. So this is pretty cool. If you want to just kind of build more of a natural ball track, you can certainly do that by putting some platforms on the roofs to kind of run some stuff. Here's greenhouse stuff, greenhouse roofs. Once again, tons and tons of options. There's so much stuff in this DLC. I was actually blown away when I first went through all this stuff before recording this video. So really not gonna show each individual one, but there's tons of different options. Really a lot. This is definitely the best of the workshop DLC so far, if I had to compare the two. So that's it for roofs. Let's look at some stairs. So if you want to get to the top of your warehouse, or if you want to make a huge multi-leveled warehouse, you can certainly do that with these stairs. Only two options there. Not really too important. And then we got some fancy doors. So let's go ahead and put a fancy door on our tiny, tiny greenhouse. And giant barn-looking doors. This is what I was talking about earlier. Guess I should take out these walls. Oh, well, looks like that didn't work out for me. Let's try and do that again. Let's place down a prefab. Go all the way back. There we go. And let's go to doors. See if we can place a nice shack door here. Well, it's supposed to connect on. You guys can tell. That's what it's supposed to do. But I think it's because it's kind of floating off of the ground that these things aren't connecting, but that's what it's supposed to do. This is really cool. A rolling metal door. This is awesome. And it's so awesome that I'm actually going to skip over to power and see what this looks like. There we go. That's really cool. And you can put like a pressure plate or something just to, you know, activate this, you know, more naturally. But I think that rolling metal door is definitely a really cool idea for this DLC. And so let's see if we have any more things in here for warehouse. Oh my god, this one section is going to take forever. It's insane. We just have some miscellaneous options, so posts, roofs, things like that. So let's move on out of warehouses and go into scaffolding. And so scaffolding is a little bit different. This is almost purely for the ball tracks. If I had to, you know, say myself and make that opinion, I would definitely say it is. And so for scaffolding, you have a lot of two different prefab options, just like this. If you just don't want to mess with pieces kind of coming together and having to worry about things fitting and whatnot, you have two prefab options that are easy to work with here. So as you can tell, I'm going to try to make them as big as I possibly can. Here we are, two different options here. One's a little bit taller and bigger than the other, but you can make some pretty large ball tracks just off of these prefabs. If you want to just start from the very top and then go down, you can absolutely do that. Then we have some little flooring options for scaffolding. So if you wanted to make little extensions off of the scaffolding, if you're actually building from the individual pieces, you can certainly do that. So just showing you guys, these are kind of just beat up makeshift things. I guess that's what scaffolding is supposed to be. So it really makes sense. And so you have all these different little floor options here, like so. That's the biggest piece right there, just kind of a normal size for a floor. So that's scaffolding floors, and here's the framework. So these are the individual pieces you can build off of. So start with a small frame just like this, and then kind of a longer frame, and as you can tell, they snap It's very finicky, but they snap onto each other. So scaffolding frame, like something you could put at the bottom, kind of larger. And then here's, you know, a skinnier, taller piece. So lots of different options. All you need is a little bit of steel and you'll be in business. So clearly there's plenty of different things to work around with if you're trying to make a specific ball track or a specific kind of Rube Goldberg machine. You can absolutely do that with the scaffolding. And so you just got a nice amount of poles and different things to work with, different kinds of stairs for your scaffolding. So if you just want to ramp up like that, this is an even cooler set of stairs, in my opinion. And so, they're really just ramps. But you also have all of these stairs, too. A ladder, which you pretty much aren't going to use like a ladder. Well, they are stairs, not a ladder. I take that back. So there we go. Lots of different stair options. Different varieties, lengths, and colors. That's what you get out of scaffolding stairs. And now we have some railing that will attach onto our scaffolding. You can tell it's being used on those prefabs. Let's go ahead and try to get it to work here. Sometimes these things are finicky, but let's check it out. So there we go. There's some floor attaching just like it should. And then under miscellaneous, let's go for the railing. There we go. It's working. And a longer rail if you want that to snap on like so. And there we go. So yeah, I think it's very easy to tell what you can do with this scaffolding. It's quite extensive, honestly. They have a lot of different options there for you to really mess around and play around. So moving into boxcars now. So there's a lot of things you can do with boxcars. There's a door right there you can put onto one of these other pieces. You have a little bit right here. And really, I think their goal with this is to allow you to make a ton of like structures with boxcars. And so there's one with kind of an ending right there. Here's a longer hallway. Here's a longer hallway with an ending. Here's a multiple entry kind of boxcar. Same thing with right here. And then also some boxcars that are kind of off the ground, which are interesting as well. And these will kind of connect to each other as long as you don't lead them out of the buildable area like I am. And so these are basically just the same versions of what we just saw, but just on these stilts up in the air. And so there's a lot of different structures you can make with these, which is really interesting. So if you wanted to make kind of a boxcar city or a section of your settlement that has boxcars, this is definitely gives you all those options. And then the same thing with orange. Very same options, but they're all just orange if you want a different color. The next new category underneath structures is elevators, and possibly the most exciting new category here. And so in terms of elevator options, we have 2 floors, 3 floors, and all the way up to 4 floors. And these will cost kind of a lot of materials for you to build, but it makes sense. Mostly it's just steel, as you can tell. Just a little bit of gear and circuitry, but you know, and copper, but wood and steel, you don't need that much of, you know, in order to build this thing. So we're just going to build that and then quickly power it up. You only need 5 power for this, so that's pretty nice. This generator right here will power, give us the power that we need. So just to demonstrate exactly how this works, go back over to structures. Actually, I need to hop out of that mode, don't I? Okay. So all I do is hop in and press the floor I want to go to. So 1, just like that. It's a little bit of a slow elevator, right? But it works exactly as intended. And we have all those different options. This goes higher than the floor of the prefab for the scaffolding, as we can tell. But elevators give us a lot of utility. And we can, you know, make our settlements more vertical a lot more easily instead of worrying with all those stairs. I know people would make some crazy stair combinations in order to get some height. But we don't have to do that anymore now that we have these elevators, which is pretty cool. And so there are your elevators, and here is the ball track. So I'm going to try to show off these items. I'm not going to try to make a super, you know, legit ball track because that would take a long time, I'm sure, to get everything working perfectly. But let's just go ahead and explore these different parts. And so actually, I'm probably just going to lay these out over here and just talk about them. So right here, we just have a simple straight ball track. And so there's 3 different options underneath ball track: straight, curves, and miscellaneous. We're going to go through each of them. So pretty much, this is, if you're not familiar, this is like a Rube Goldberg machine creator. all of these different options are. And so what you can do is send balls down these tracks and then through different powered gates that can serve different purposes for you. And there's a lot of machinery we're going to get into later in this video that will make more sense. And so you have different versions. Some of these are supported and then not supported, kind of the same version of each of them. And so you can kind of mix and match and connect all of these, and they'll kind of curve around. As you can see, I can just flip this around, and if it has enough momentum, it'll go back up, as you can tell. And so, yeah, I can make it go back down, make it go up a little bit more, and up and up and up. And so there's a lot of different things you can do with the straight ones, but then, of course, we have the curvy ones. Let's go ahead and hop in here. So if I wanted to curve my ball track around, that's all I need to do. Put a nice little curve there. Put a curve back. If I want to make it go back up, if it has enough momentum, I can do that as well. Can make another version of that. Yeah, so we have 180 degrees. We have a 360 degree ball track curve right here. So really, if you just mix and match these, you can make this into any shape that you really want to. There's enough tools here to do what you need to do with these ball tracks, which is really cool. There's also some extra stuff in here, like a funnel. So if you have a lot of different balls coming in, and, you know, let's say there's 5 balls coming in, and they just need to go in one by one into the next part of your ball track, you can certainly do that as well. So just go ahead and place that right there. And a funnel as well. So you have, if you have multiple balls coming in through a funnel and they need to go down the bottom, here's also a funnel with a chute. So if you want to do that as well and send them down, that will achieve that. Here's one that will merge two different tracks into one, which is pretty cool. And that works with two different balls. Let's just go ahead and place this down here. I just want to... Okay, well, I actually have to move that or something else. But anyways, here's the ball drop. So this is something you would put at the top of a scaffolding kind of prefab. So if I were to go up here and put just a ball drop, if I go up here and put a ball in and then activate it, it'll drop that ball and begin the entire sequence. And so that's pretty cool as well. And then here is a powered ball drop. So if I, you know, flip a switch, I can do that instead of going up and actually hitting activate on that little gate to send the ball down. Here's some supporters if you ever need these. I guess these are probably if, you know, you can't get some of these tracks to work exactly how you want to do them, or you want them to look more natural, you have supporters for that. Here's a split that will actually change if you power it. So if you have a power switch, if you want to step on it or something, or have something else activate this power switch, it'll switch the track that you're going down, which is very clever. Here's another switch. So if you want to use your balls to power, you know, some sort of machine, you can attach it via wire to the top of this, and that's how that'll work. This is the same thing, except it's a pulse. So it turns on briefly whenever it's triggered, but then it'll go back off. Whereas this first one just, you know, turns on or off each time it's triggered. So guys, there's so much you can do with this stuff. I mean, it's really hard to explain just in this brief overview video, but you can tell there's so many different tools that you can mess around with. Moving on, there are no new items in furniture, so you don't have to worry about that. But under decorations, we have a brand new category called display. And this is something a lot of people were excited about. First off, we have armor racks. So let's go ahead and take a look at these. These are just creepy kind of mannequins. You can also creep yourself out by placing these around your settlement at night, you know, if you really want to do that. But this is very simple. All you do is put these down. So just like so. And then I'll just show you guys. You just go up, click E to use. And then if I want my mannequin to wear some glasses, hopefully glasses work. Oh, you have to equip them. So you have to go in and equip them. There we go. It's a pretty cool looking mannequin, right? Yeah, so that's how the armor racks work. Very simple if you just want to display your armor. And they have a female version as well. So that's cool as well. So we also have a bunch of display cases just to kind of show off stuff, which is really cool. And so if you want to place these around, you can show off a lot of the stuff you found, which is awesome. Actually, I would love to just go ahead and collect like all of the rare or legendary items in the game and then just go ahead and place them in display cases all around my settlement. This is essentially what this allows you to do. Or you could do something goofy like put a Jangles the Moon Monkey in one of these if you were really that kind of person, which, you know, there's plenty of people like that. So let's go ahead and show you guys some of these can be powered. And I believe this will just put a light on it. Okay, well, we're just going to ignore that. I'm pretty sure that the power displays light up. And so if you want to do that, that's also really cool if you want them to show at night. Which, you know, why wouldn't you, right? So that's what we have under the display category. Oh, no, we have more. We have a power armor display. So these just come in different colors. They're all the same items. But really cool here, you can just walk your power armor up, and as you can tell, there's a little light there. So if you're able to power this, this will kind of light up and really show off your power armor in a really cool way, which is awesome as well. And then we have weapon racks. So there's a heavy weapon stand for your fat mans, your miniguns, your things like that. And then you can place stuff on walls, weapon racks on walls. So your shorter weapons will go on this one. Let's just go find a wall in order to place this stuff and actually show you guys. So you can go up like that. Long weapons can go up like that. Pistol racks if you just want to set up your pistols. So let's place some of our weapons on that wall just to show off what it looks like. You can just go up and transfer items just like you would with any container. So, for example, if I want to put my really awesome 10mm pistol on the wall, there we go. And I'm sure I can fit, let's see, can I fit more? Looks like that's just for one. Let's do a hunting rifle on this long one. There we go. Nice little hunting rifle. That looks tiny on there. But you guys pretty much get the gist. You can display all of your cool stuff in that way. This guy's really creeping me out as I'm making this video. Just keep walking by and thinking it's an actual person. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this section, the display section. And we also have a new section. I believe this is new. People pointed this out, and it's got a plus sign next to it, so I'm just going to include it. And that's posters. And these require power to light up. So they're kind of really cool light-up posters if you want to make a movie theater kind of looking thing, or you just want to make a really fancy display. You can pick from a ton of different posters. I mean, really, there's like 50 in here. It's kind of like all the posters they added in that free update. And also with Wasteland Workshop, I think they added a few things like this. But as you can tell, there's a ton of different little posters you can set up here. Tons of different options. And so, pretty much if you want to do some cosmetic stuff with your settlement, these new options are here for you. Now we're moving into the final category. There's nothing in defense, resources, stores, crafting, or cages that's new. It's all in power, and that kind of makes sense. And so we're just going to move in here, and I'm also going to create a big generator over here just kind of to make sure if we ever need to power something for this, that we will be ready for that. And so the first new little category within power is connectors and switches. New stuff within the category, but not completely new. And it's way at the end. It's really interesting machines. We've got the firing target pulse, which can go over here. Let's just go ahead and put it right here for example purposes. The firing target toggle, which is the same thing, but it toggles on off every time instead of just, you know, going on briefly whenever it's struck. That's the pulse one. And then a power counter. And so each of these items is very interesting. This first one, you know, basically there's a ball shooting machine. It's a pitching machine, just like you would find in baseball, but in this game. And so if you have some kind of Rube Goldberg machine over here, let's say, and you have a ball coming through that triggers the, you know, the pitching machine. Actually, let's go over to the pitching machine right now. I believe I know where it is. I think it's under miscellaneous. Okay, we'll forget that. We'll get to it in a second. But if you set up the pitching machine and it hits this, this will, you know, switch on power for something else. And it's just, you know, one of those other options if you want to make some kind of complex machine. Same thing with this. It's just a toggle like I explained. And then this other one is actually interesting. Let's go into the description so I don't butcher this. Transmits power briefly after cycling power every 10 times, but you can attach a terminal to change that maximum count to make it lower or higher, I'm sure, as well. And so this is also just another one of those tools if you want to make a really complex machine. And I will be making other videos showing you guys exactly how to use these things. I need a little bit more experience to show you guys. But let's go into the next category under conduits. And this is really important stuff, in my opinion, because this allows you to relay power in a way that you just couldn't do before. And so you've got a four-way junction right here, and then a three-way like this. I'm literally just going to attach all these items just to show you guys exactly what you can do with all of this. And so we've got the same thing with a junction, but it's also got a little connector on top for power. So if you want to use that for that, you can do it that way. Same thing. We've got kind of a three-way connection there. Let's kind of angle this back downwards. And so as you can tell, lots of different options here. Then we've got one that ends. So let's just put that on the end right there. This is a power radiator. And so I'm not exactly sure what this does, if I'm being honest with you guys. I'll probably have to do some more testing with that, but it's one of those little funky options, and also this light as well. So this will light up if you connect it via a power source. So as you can tell, we've got a lot of different ways we can connect wires together through conduits. And then we have these extended wires here, and these are crazy. Like, you got that short one, you got this long one, you got this extra long one that can, you know, transmit that power signal even further, that connection rather. And then you have little rounded off sections. And then you have a long rounded off section. It's absolutely insane. Here's a short little turn. And this will go upwards, stand up on its own. This one is a pass through. So I believe you can connect this through a wall. Let's just connect. It says wall pass through. So let's just figure out. Yeah. So look at that. That will work right there. So if I want to have my generators outside of my giant warehouse, I can do that. And then this will go through the wall. Very, very cool. Here's just another conduit. Let's see if we can get this to work. Okay, well, that's apparently going to connect like that too. And here's another one that's a wall pass through. And these will go on your roof or up here. That's probably not going to work because... But yeah, these will go like on a roof, for example. So inside of your warehouse on the top, if you want to make these. And they're pretty much the same versions of what we already have. And this is really cool too. This is a conduit switch. So if I want to activate the power to all these different, you know, connections, I can do that via one switch. And so the conduit section of power is definitely going to give you guys a lot of different building capabilities. So there's nothing new in lights, but there is some new stuff in miscellaneous that I just talked about. So I believe I passed the pitching machine. Yeah, I did. So this is the pitching machine right here, what I was just talking to you guys about. So I believe this is the way it shoots out. Yeah. So let's just put this really close, for example. It's probably not going to work because I don't think it's on the same even surface, but I believe I also have to put some baseballs in there as well in order to make that work. But yeah, essentially, if I were to have this working in the way it should be working, then I would have baseballs shooting out of the bottom part here and going and hitting that on the same level. And that would, you know, be able to trigger some power options, which is really cool. But check this out, guys, the junk mortar. This shoots junk. I honestly don't know what the purpose of this is. I think you could probably incorporate this with some of the machines. But as you can tell, when you connect the power, it's just going to work like that. And you can actually change the angle of the junk mortar as well to shoot at different angles. Very, very cool machines here. And I'm sure you could fill this up with the little steel balls, send them all the way down your Rube Goldberg machine to land in here, and then transmit a power signal to shoot it off. Like, I can absolutely see that happening. I mean, that's just one of the many ways that you can do some crazy shit in this DLC. Also, we have the firework mortar. So we can shoot off fireworks. You can actually manufacture fireworks as well. So you can be loaded with firework shells, fire as long as they are powered. You can make a delayed switch, which is something I definitely recommend. So if you want to, at the end of your machine, if you do some crazy thing with your ball, it goes all the way down and then triggers a firework at the end, you can shoot off some fireworks, which are very cool. This is also a really cool thing, and you can incorporate this with the junk mortar, I'm sure. You can set up hoops whenever something goes through. As you can tell, that little lever kind of flipped up. It can, you know, activate that and then activate something else if you've connected it via a wire or a conduit or something else. And you can also just put a hoop switch on the wall. Hopefully I can just place this on the wall over here. Yeah, just like that. And so same basic thing right there. Very, very cool stuff. And then I believe all these power speakers are new. I can't confirm that for sure, but let's just show you guys exactly what's going on here. So this will play a tone, and then these are all different kinds of tones. So we have pulse, vibrato, sine, square, triangle, all these different things. And so let's just go ahead and do explosions. So that just made a very small noise. And I guess that's just for effect if you'd like to do that with your awesome complex machines. We also have advanced switches. And we're pretty much nearing the end, the last few categories. But there's still so many more cool things. And I really couldn't tell you guys. I really need to mess around with this stuff a lot more to talk intelligently about these what these logic gates do. But it does give you kind of a brief description of what happens. Transmits power of... Okay. Yeah, so... This tells you exactly what all of these different categories do. And so I'm just going to sit here for a second, let you guys read. You can pause the video if you want to learn more about them in this video. But I will, again, be going over probably a whole episode of tips and tricks on logic gate very soon on my channel. Okay, so gave you guys an opportunity to just pause right there and look at all that. But I'm going to place all these. And they have little, symbols on each of them to show you exactly how they're different. Or you could, if you could just, you know, spot them from a distance, if you need to know what an advanced switch is. And you could just look at the little symbol and you will know. But there you go. All the different logic gates right there. You can do so many cool things with that. But we're now going to get into the bread and butter. I'm actually going to change the time of day and we'll be right back. Now we're going to look at the last two categories, that's manufacturing and marquee. But manufacturing is definitely the big one. There are so many things that are really important to this DLC that let you do a lot of things. So we have conveyor belts, machinery, and miscellaneous. Starting with conveyor belts, this is pretty obvious. This is how you're going to be able to move a lot of the objects that you're going to be able to produce. Actually, before we go into conveyor belts, I think it makes more sense to look into machinery. And so machinery, these are a series of machines that allow you to just produce items once you make this machine. However, you will need the materials to build some of these items. And so the builder is something that just builds miscellaneous things like a lot of junk. And so if I just place this down and connect a terminal, it'll give me a nice set of items that I can actually build out of this. And so I'm just going to build each of these things right next to each other. So yeah, you can tell right here, new objects out of the objects in its inventory. Whatever you place into here, it'll automatically create. And then if you connect a conveyor belt, it'll automatically feed into that, which is really, really cool. And then you can change that via the terminal connected to the same power grid. And this is going to be the same thing for all of these. As we can tell here, we can create armor, and there aren't a billion options. You know, don't get crazy. We can't create like combat armor, for example. That would just be OP, right? But you need armor rank 1 in order to create the armor forge, and these require a lot of power, obviously. We also have a weapon forge. Same thing. We're not going to create ridiculous weapons, but there's a lot of different variety within the weapon forge. And auto loom will allow you to create clothes, so certain kind of you know, cosmetic things that aren't ridiculously overpowered. Maybe a few pieces you can put ballistic weave on, but really nothing more than that. Energy weapons, same thing. You can build certain energy weapons, heavy weapons as well. So you need gun nut for that. Also, you need a rank 2 of science for the energy weapon forge. And you can also create ammo, which you need gun nut and science in order to do. Explosives, you can create different explosives as well. You just need rank 2 of demolition expert in order to do this. And so that's also an option. Pyrotechnics, this is for those fireworks that we saw before. And so in order to do that, you need to create that. And then you could also create food, a lot of pre-war items, kind of the junk food that you find around, sugar bombs, you know, crisps, stuff like that. And so you can create a lot of stuff out of the food processor as well. So let's go ahead and create a terminal just to see all the different options there. So I've connected all of these different builders together onto this one fusion generator, and now I've got the terminal right here. So let's go ahead and hop into this terminal and see all the different options that we can mess around with. So as you can tell, every single thing can be connected to one terminal, and then you can control all of your different forges and plants and mills and all kinds of things. So just looking at heavy weapons, for example, we can create a Fat Man, a Gauss rifle, a minigun, and missile launcher. These seem like really powerful things, right? And they are, but you will need the components for each individual thing. And so you will need to provide each of these things in order to build a Fat Man. And this goes for absolutely everything in here. It doesn't seem like you can just create something from scratch. I need cloth and adhesive to make a denim dress, for example, if I really wanted that for my male character. You know, my male character likes to wear a dress. Let's not judge him. Pyrotechnics, you can make all kinds of different fireworks and whatnot. Oh, you can make different shells that change the weather. I didn't actually know that. So you can create a rad storm, rain, and you can make everything clear as well within the game. You don't need mods or cheats or anything to do that. That is very cool that they added that option as well. So for food, I can create things like, you know, mac and cheese, fancy lads, snack cakes, all kinds of things. Let's just look at the general builder here. Yeah, you can just create a bunch of junk, a bunch of different things. Jangles the Moon Monkey, of course, people are going to create that, obviously. Armor, we can create leather armor, metal armor, and combat armor. Would you look at that? You can actually create combat armor in 3 different variations, light, medium, and heavy. So I was wrong about that earlier. You can do this, but you will need things like ballistic fiber in order to pull that off. And you will need, you know, smaller amounts for, you know, lesser combat armor, but you can absolutely create combat armor. And I think it's, you know, completely fair because you do need ballistic fiber. That's something you don't find absolutely everywhere. So this is something, if you have all the materials that you can build early on in the game, you can get yourself some really good combat armor fairly early on. Those are all the different manufacturing things you can mess around with. And there's so many more things you can do. I'm really just scratching the surface with this basic overview. And so let's go back into here, back into manufacturing, and look at conveyor belts. And so very simply, this is what you're dealing with. So if I were to create something, there we go. And if it's attached, it's automatically powered if there's enough, you know. Or actually, it just needs a power connection. You can see it just requires that power symbol. It doesn't require a certain amount of power, just that it is connected to power. So we have this short little piece here, a longer piece here, a piece that actually branches out. And so you can tell, you know, if you have a massive, huge warehouse, you could do so many things with this. It's insane. Here's a left branch. And actually, this has another connection that I'll show you guys. And so this can just all branch off in different ways. It can go downward, so I can make this go down. Even more conveyor belts that just float into the air. Left turns, right turns. It looks like these just don't have the bottoms that we're normally used to. And so lots of different options there. Different versions of the same stuff. Here's some rollers. So if it has, you know, enough momentum, it'll go on those rollers and keep rolling. And then these rollers go downward if you want to kind of guide these into a receptacle. Here are rollers that actually curve outwards like that. Rollers that curve the other way. So let's go ahead and do that. See, we can connect that right there. Now here's a diverter, which is interesting. This is kind of an attachment that you can put on some of these different branching off pieces. And so I'm going to go ahead and put this on the branch over here. Yeah. So if you power this up, it's actually going to cut this off and divert stuff over there. So I'm just going to build a small generator just to show it off because it's really cool stuff. There. So if I had a little switch maybe or some kind of detection piece that said, hey, oh, we need to divert stuff over there, I could do that. And if I didn't want that, could just get rid of it, turn the power off, and it goes back to normal. It'll go down that, you know, central guiding area. Very cool stuff. Let's see what else we have within conveyor belts. And so we have a right diverter that'll do the same thing, but on the other side. And then we have a lift. So if I want to put this at the very end, guide everything up here, it would lift stuff up to the very top and kind of drop them. This is something we saw in the trailer with Mama Murphy dropping stuff on her. And then we have all these different lift options that'll go in different directions. So that'll go left, that goes up and basically back, that goes left, left, or not left, this is a lift, but different directions, as you can tell. Lots of different options for the conveyor belt lifts. And then we have laser trip wires that can actually transmit power. So if I wanted to say connect this to, you know, the diverter right there, this requires power as well. So you will need another power source. If I were to put something there and then pass by this, it would trigger that diverter and move stuff over. So very, very cool stuff. Let's see. Did I miss anything else? And then also a switch, a different version of that tripwire. Lots of different options there. Now let's look at the very final category in this entire DLC of new things. It's the miscellaneous category of manufacturing under power. And here is the hopper. So this will basically collect things. If you want to drop stuff out of one of these lifts, it'll go inside this hopper, go back down, and then you could do a lot of different things there, divert it in different directions. This is a sorter. And so, oh, there's the alien craft. Interesting. So this is a sorter. So if I am guiding a ton of things down one giant conveyor belt, and then I want to sort certain things out, for example, let's just do that. I can actually put stuff into this inventory. So let's back out here. I can transfer what I want to be sorted out, and it'll spit out only what I want or send them in certain directions, which is very, very cool. So let's hop back into there. So we've got that sorter. We've got a component sorter. So that's based on, you know, the actual components. So as you guys know, you can split stuff into component view and whatnot in your inventory. This is basically the same premise, same function here. So lots of different things you can do with that. Here's a storage. And so this is stuff that'll store what you're delivering. So you don't have to just drop it on the ground. It can go into this one container and then you can go and collect everything at the very end after you're done, you know, manufacturing it. And this will pull stuff out of a container. So I'll have to see how this works. I don't see, this isn't like connecting onto certain things, but as we can tell, it says you pull items out of adjacent containers whenever powered on. So there's additional things you can do to just sort items. I mean, guys, there's so much stuff. I was actually really surprised in this DLC. Actually, that wasn't the last thing, though. We still have marquees. I totally forgot about that. So these are like light up signs that require power if you want to kind of make some cool, fancy little signs that kind of decorate your complex machines. You can do that. But you also have the marquee sign here. So if you want to make some fun little sign letters, and they go in different categories. So there's A, B, see, they have, you know, they go on specific parts. There's like little cells for each individual thing you want to put on here. You can do that as well. You know, I can put JV's, you know, machine. So, guys, there's so much cool stuff in this DLC. I mean, I'm really blown away that this is $5. So anyways, guys, I'd like to hear your thoughts on this DLC. If you've bought it, are you enjoying it? Does it look impressive? If you haven't bought it, does this make you want to buy it and build some really cool machines? Share what you're thinking in the comment section below. Alright guys, today I shared an overview of all the new items in the Contraptions Workshop DLC pack for Fallout 4. Next time we will cover more Fallout on my channel, so stay tuned for Fallout 4 tips and tricks videos. If you learned something new or enjoyed this video, remember to hit that like button, I would really appreciate it. And don't forget to subscribe for more Contraptions DLC coverage, my survival mode live streams, Bethesda.net mods, and general tips and tricks videos. Talk to you guys next time. Peace!